wrestling fans, welcome into this week's edition of Championship Wrestling. Hope you've enjoyed all the action of all of our wrestling programs, and I tell you, we've got a good one on tap for you today. We've got action from the Showboat Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada. The 1986 AWA Rookie of the Year, Jeff Jarrett, who's climbing that ladder very quickly. He's in tag team action with Stoney Burt as they take on a tough tag team called the Nasty Boys. Also, a little bit later on, we've got a close-up interview with Jerry Bryant and Big Lou. They're known as the Memphis Vice. They've returned to our area, and they are a strong, tough tag team. We'll be talking with them a little bit later on. Big Bubba will be in action against the Mountain Maniac. Two big fellas in that ring, plus a whole lot more. We got all that action coming up next, right here on Championship Wrestling. Championship Wrestling, the Las Vegas Showboat Arena, an outstanding hall for wrestling action, an outstanding competition going on right now. The 1986 AWA Rookie of the Year, Jeff Jarrett, teaming up with Stoney Burke against the Nasty Boys. Let's look at it right now.
This is a tag team match. And in this corner right here, we have Jeff Jarrett from Hendersonville, Tennessee, the AWA Rookie of the Year at 225 pounds. His tag team partner from Seattle, Washington at 235. He is Stoney Burke.
Boys, they have a way of getting nasty before some matches even ever begin.
Absolutely. They just look mean when they come out there.
The Nasty Boys are Jerry Sag, 270, Brian Knobbs, 285. They certainly have a very, very distinct weighted belly over their opponents, Stoney Burke and Jeff Jarrett. Burke, 235. Checking the weight. Jeff Jarrett.
Hey, you ugly people.
Had a couple of chances to watch Jeff in action. And despite the fact he weighs 208 pounds, don't let that fool you. He is very, very capable. Handles himself extremely well in that squared ring. And the Nasty Boys will find that out before this one is all over. Right now, you have Stoney Burke out of Seattle in with Brian Knobbs. One thing about these Nasty Boys, whether you like them or not, they have learned, and they've learned very, very quickly, that one of the great successes of a tag team combination is tagging in and out very quickly.
Absolutely. They work very well as a team. But I'll tell you what, I think that they're going to realize here in a hurry that they got two young men in there that can really wrestle.
And that's Jeff Jarrett right there. You, of course, longtime tag team partner of Nick Bockwinkel. What's the secret of success of becoming tag team champions of the world?
Well, the secret of success is that you have to learn to be a team. You can't go out there and be working with one person. And, broke his shoulder on that.
Wow, I guess so.
Stoney Burke taking it right to him, giving him all they want.
Stoney Burke from Seattle. Really, whipping the Nasty Boys. Jerry Sag and Brian Knobbs around with a series of arm drags. Talking about it is a team. You don't do it alone.
Absolutely. Tony Burke's giving them all they want right by himself right now. Now, I don't know how long him and Jarrett have wrestled as a team, but they both got good credentials as individuals. They can handle themselves. Jarrett is a rookie of the year. Has wrestled Nick Bockwinkel when Nick held the heavyweight championship. So that says something for him.
The Southeastern AWA Rookie of the Year. We haven't seen him in action in this one yet. Now we are about to, as Tony Burke tags him in. And here comes Jeff Jarrett. Very impressive opening move. How about encores? Well, he's showing us right now. Jeff Jarrett working on the left arm of Brian Knobbs of the Nasty Boys. But Knobbs grabs a hold of that hair, not once, but twice. But Jarrett hangs on to the hold. Three times he grabs the hair and takes him to the canvas. Jarrett chases Knobbs out of the ring.
Now, that's a little defense, a little strategy that Knobbs is trying to use there. Get out of the way. Show a little tiny too, perhaps.
Maybe the Nasty Boys, both Zag and Knobbs, feel that because Jarrett is only 208 pounds, he's a piece of cake. Well, they're finding out differently.
Oh, yeah, they're finding that out in a hurry, that this young man knows where he's going when he's in that ring.
Somewhat of a look of concern on the face of Brian Knobbs as he hooks up with Jarrett, who immediately goes to an armbar and a twist and an Irish whip. Oh! Now that takes tremendous timing and coordination, and Jarrett has it all. I'm impressed, Ray Stevens. Oh, indeed. Get a good look at him right there. Great camera work, as always, here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Vegas. An impressive tag team combination. Stoney Burke and Jeff Jarrett. This is Stoney Burke. One of the Nasty Boys, that one being Brian Knobbs, going to the eyes of Stoney Burke, stopping him cold and tagging in Jerry Sags. Sags from the second rope. A double sledge across the middle of the back. Again, Sags. And it is Burke being slammed to the canvas. Here's Sags. Stoney Burke gets out of the way. And here is Jeff Jarrett. And the crowd loves him. The Nasty Boys do not. Understandably so. Look at it go. He should have had three. Sag came in and saved the day for the Nasty Boys. Double whip on Knobbs. Stoney Burke for the cover.
Well, he got out of there by the skin of his teeth.
Oh, did he ever? Did he ever? Hard shoulder blocks here by Stoney Burke. Uh-oh. Disqualification coming here.
Before they could chew, and I think you're right, Rod. They threw him over the top rope to save the embarrassment of getting beat.
Absolutely no two ways about it. Maybe you heard it, maybe you didn't. Gary DeRusso, the referee, coming over and announcing his decision, giving the match to Burke and Jarrett.
Oh, yeah, Evansville, get ready. Wednesday night, that Coliseum is going to be bubbling over, my friend, because, I mean, there's some double-aught action you won't forget. Lawler and Brickhouse in a main event that we'll be telling you about a little bit later on. And I got to also tell you that the U.S. Tag Team Champions, Steve Kern and Ron Simmons, will be right in Evansville to defend those titles against the Nasty Boys.
Evansville. Evansville.
Yes, sir.
Do you know how stupid you gotta be to sit on a tractor for 9 hours? You gotta have a frontal lobotomy, man. You gotta be crazy. You dumb farmers don't know how much of a privilege it is to see the Nasty Boys live in Technicolor. You better kiss our feet when we come into that ring.
You remember you're going for the U.S.
We don't care what we're going for. We're just going to destroy them, and that's all that's to it, because we are class, and we are flat on the AWA, and we have it all.
Well, I don't think they've ever seen Steve Kern in that. Downtown Bruno, you got enough of your own problems. Be careful.
You know what? I don't have no problems. I got the Moondogs against Jeff Jarrett and Big Bubba. Let me tell you something. The Moondogs is the craziest and the baddest and the wildest tag team in professional wrestling. Here's Jeff Jarrett, a little goofball, and Big Bubba, a big pig. Ain't no problem there. And Prime Time is going to be there in Evansville, Indiana. And they speak for themselves, Lance Russell.
Well, I know they speak for themselves.
You know, Lance Russell, there's three things wrong with Dundee and Johnson.
Back.
Yeah, Pat, come on. Three things wrong with Dundee and Johnson now. One, they're washed up. We give them chance after chance. They couldn't beat us. So then, of course, George Barnes had to hit Pat Tanaka with the chair for them to win.
Mm-hmm.
Two, they're yellow belly cowards. We asked for a rematch. What they say? Oh, no, you can't have a rematch. And three, they're very, very stupid. We asked for a martial arts match, and they agreed. Do you know we got on a team? Look right here. The man himself, Pat Tanaka.
That's right.
Yeah, everybody thinks that Bruce Lee trained me. He didn't. I did. I trained Bruce Lee.
Oh.
You remember that.
Yeah, okay.
And when you step in the ring, Judson, remember.
On Championship Wrestling, Big Bubba and the Mountain Maniac. Let's go to the action.
Big Bubba, 404 Miami, Florida, going against the Mountain Maniac, 323. Not too many times that the Mountain Maniac is going to look up and see somebody bigger than he is, but thus is the case tonight. Pulled by the Mountain Maniac, and he's backed up. Bruno bringing in another brute to try to do something to Big Bubba. Whole difference in these two. Bubba, who spent a lot of time in the gym training, and if that is the case with the Mountain Maniac, I fail to see it. Achilles toe. Look at that Bubba. Leaping on the big guy. Down he goes. Nope, Bruno, I don't think this is your man. Count of one, two, three. He got him. Bubba! That is not the guy that's going to collect a bounty for beating up on Big Bubba. 225, the winner, Big Bubba. 225.
Championship Wrestling taking you to arenas all across the Mid-South. Let's go to some action right now.
Bell has sounded, and we're just about ready for the action to begin in this one fall 15-minute time limit period. Tony Burton starting out for the team of Tony Burton and John Paul and Phil Hickerson. Security chief of Tojo Yamamoto's organization. Hickerson and Tojo against Tony Burton and John Paul, the referee, Frank Morrell. Hickerson discussing with the referee the fact that Burton was pulling his hair. What he did was pull his arm. Hickerson will probably say he had a hold of the tight. No, 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 he's still on the hair.
I call you.
No!
Armbar and a tag on John Paul, youngster from Minneapolis, Minnesota. And a reversal by Hickerson. John Paul turned him over and dropped on him. Slides right into a nice armbar up tight. Good move. Tag on Tony. You know there is no love lost between Yamamoto and Tony Burton, as Burton was a student of Tojo Yamamoto. Burton keeps checking over his shoulder to look at Yamamoto. Also, Hickerson grabs a hair and bounces Burton off the mat. Tony telling the referee, and the referee said, "Did you pull his hair?" Phil said, "No. Ask Tojo." You know what that'll get you. Up top with a wrist lock goes Hickerson. That was a good quick move. No less than 1,000 times, I guess we've said how amazing it is that Hickerson can move with the speed that he moves at his side. Ooh, John Paul takes over in a very positive way again. He's trying to take Phil down, but Hickerson pounds him with a right hand, and Gann comes back. And the roughneck from Jackson, Tennessee, bounces the head of John Paul off the turnbuckle. Look at Tojo. Oh, right to the midsection. Big solid chop. Went right for the throat on that chop. John Paul being roughed around the ring by Yamamoto and Phil Hickerson. 3 minutes of action in this tag match with Burton and Paul against Yamamoto and Hickerson. To the corner, and Hickerson grabs him from outside, pulls the hair, and snaps his head right off that top rope. Big chop from Tojo. Tag on Hickerson. John Paul trying to fight his way back, but Hickerson on a roll now, whips him across into the ropes. Eddie Elbow puts him down flat on his back. Tag on Tojo. And John Paul still battling his way out of trouble, but unable to get away from Yamamoto, who sends a series of searing chops at him. In a neutral corner, Yamamoto follows and digs into the back as he rakes it down. 4 minutes in with 11 minutes to go. Hickerson receives the tag. Takes a shot to that ample midsection. Doesn't faze him one bit. Straight up and over the shoulder. Slams him down. John Paul, who's been in there for 3 minutes or better and taking nothing but hard knuckles from Phil Hickerson and chops from Yamamoto. Tag again to Tojo. Tojo gouging away at the eyes, nose, and mouth of John Paul. Paul stinging him with that right hand, but Tojo can't see exactly what he's doing, but you can bet it has something to do with the eyes, and it was paid off with Hickerson tagging in from Yamamoto. Bam! Bill. Ooh, hearty chop there. With a whip into the corner, and an elbow puts Bill flat. Cover, one, nope. Yamamoto Nickerson. Come on, Phil. Come on, Phil. Tony went over for a backdrop. Look at this. One, two. That's going to be in three. 6:07. The winner is Nickerson and Yamamoto.
Memphis Vice, they've returned to our area. You may remember them from before. Big Lou and Jerry Bryant. Lance Russell had a chance to take a look at these fellas, talk to them up close and personal. Let's go to that right now.
Sitting here with the opportunity for the first time, as a matter of fact, and we wanted to on many occasions before. We just haven't been able to get the schedules right. The Memphis Vice, Jerry Bryant, and Big Lou Winston. By golly, thanks, guys, for getting here with us a little bit.
Thanks for inviting us back, Lance. We're glad to be back.
Lou, you're looking... What is this, a new look? We got a little mustache and hair chopped off by Lou?
Yeah, the new Memphis Vice.
That's it, baby.
My golly, I tell you what, you guys were really on a roll, and I know that this may be a sore subject in the fact that it wasn't the happiest moment in your life, but your train kind of got slowed down by a chest injury that you had, Jerry.
Yeah, I got kicked in the chest one night, and it didn't bother me for like a couple of 3 weeks, and I had some serious blockage around my heart where I had blood off in it. And I tell you what, Lance, it's been a long 6 months. They said I'd never wrestle again. I was in the hospital for almost 2 months and on a rehab program for another 2.5 months. And Big Lou, he backed off the weights and got into aerobics. Look how slim and trim he is. And I tell you what, the Memphis Vice is back, and I'm going to tell you something else. We're looking forward to getting a chance with those belts.
Yeah, I wondered, Lou, when Jerry was kind of laid up like that, whether you might go ahead and pursue it as a single or maybe pick up another partner.
Well, you know, I thought about just pursuing as a single at first, and then I felt like the chemistry with Brian Winston was there. So, you know, I just got in the gym, worked out, did aerobics, and now we're ready.
I do tell you one thing. You make a great accommodation in the size. I don't know what you're weighing now, Lou. You used to be about 253, 254, and you've trimmed up, but you had the big size and the speed that you had, Jerry. Have you still got that same speed that we know JB with?
I got it, Lancer. I got all the things I need, and the main thing, we got a lot of heart. A lot of people said the Memphis Vice, they're so cocky. You can call it cocky or you can call it confidence. We have to be high on something, and we're high on ourselves. We enjoy getting after people. We enjoy wrestling, and we'll be the first one to knock you down and laugh at you in a minute, man. We will.
He's not telling you anything that isn't the absolute truth, and they've knocked a lot of them down. I think, Lou, that probably you guys have surprised as many of the big-name teams as anybody I know of. They've heard of the Memphis Vice and all of that, but they really didn't expect to be as good as you guys have turned out to be.
We turned out pretty good, Lance, because we work hard together. We talk, you know, we're good friends, and we work out a lot together.
Yeah, are you back in the gym where you can work out and all?
Oh, yeah, we work out 4 days a week now.
All right.
So we work out real hard. We watch our tapes. We watch other matches. We watch new guys that come in the territory. We even watch some other people's not even in our territory. But if it looks good, if it works, and if it wins matches and makes your money, that's what the Memphis Vice wants to do.
You heard a great summary right there from Jerry Bryant, Big Lou Winston, the Memphis Vice. Let me tell you, they're back, and they're better than ever before. We are looking forward to seeing them once again in the ring. Plenty of action coming from the Memphis Vice.
So now you know a little bit more about the Memphis Vice. Let's go back to the studio right now for some action from our studios of Championship Wrestling.
Brickhouse Brown, the new Southern Heavyweight Champion. Dave?
All right. This is going to be a non-title match. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Out of Memphis, Tennessee, at 204 pounds, Ed Maddox. And going against him, at 225 from Miami, Florida, Brickhouse Brown. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
The bell time is sounded. Ed Maddox beating Brickhouse head-on, but not for long.
Ed Maddox, an underdog in the match, no doubt about it, as he comes in here, but... what a suplex. Brickhouse put a move on him, let me tell you. Got around beside him and just used Ed's own weight and took him right back into the mat.
Brickhouse is not only powerful, he spent a lot of time in the gym building those muscles up, but he is quick. Hey, boy, I'll tell you, that's been the most impressive thing I've seen about him. He is very fast.
He's working on Ed Maddox. Maddox now back up on his feet, helped on his feet by Brickhouse. Brickhouse helped him into the ropes and hit him with the upper arm coming off there. Look at him, get in the air. He dropped down with the fist doubled up when he hit him in the head. Ed Maddox, not having any luck so far against Brickhouse Brown. Look out, here he comes. He flying through the air
in the middle of that ring.
Maddox trying to battle back.
Want some more, huh?
Brickhouse with a headbutt. Down to the mat, Ed Maddox.
Brickhouse doing his own commentary as he goes through the match with Ed Maddox in here instead of going in there and just wrestling. Brickhouse Brown totally dominating the action with Ed Maddox. He was, of course, the favorite. He turned him over.
He didn't just clothesline him. He let him have it with that right hand. There's a cover, two, and a very confident three count for Brickhouse Brown. 1 minute, 49 seconds the time on it. And Brickhouse, as you said, the word is dominate. He dominated that match.
Little showboat by the new Southern heavyweight champion, Brickhouse Brown, as he came out victorious over Ed Maddox, and no surprise. Well, what was that time again?
A minute 49 seconds.
Okay. Well, Brickhouse has yet to see the final day of that Southern heavyweight title. I can say that with all the confidence in the world. Here comes the guy that he took it from. He's inviting Brickhouse to step back up in the ring. We'll take care of our business right here and now. I'm talking about, obviously, the team and the crowd saying, oh, yeah, go get him. Stunning shock when the king lost the crown, no question about it. Lawler hops up on the edge of the ring and says, be my guest any way you want it.
Across the Mid-South. Let's go to some action right now.
Allen West, 252. Muscle builder out of Zuma Beach, California. And he's outweighed. Not in the same beautiful proportions that West has, but 301 packed on that stocky frame of the star from Greasy Corner, Arkansas, singing cowboy Don Bass. West powers his arm into a hammer. Right to the ropes, gets himself a break. Referee Frank Morrell. Don Bass telling the referee he had his fingers separated and spread apart in there, which is illegal. Didn't look like it to us, though. Bass just used that superior weight to put him on the rope, but Allen West fires back with a right and into a standing headlock. Stays right on him with that headlock. Shot a right, didn't pass. Whoa. And he took a couple. Allen smothers him with that standing side headlock.
Oh.
are Boss Winters, who is in the corner of Don Bass, hollering that it's all hair pulling, fist doubled up, and all of that. Oh, boy. Alan West firing right back at Don Bass. The rugged veteran is not scaring this young fella from California at all. Misses him with a big left hand. As he didn't cross body him, but he had his arms together and lifted up straight up on him, knocked Don back. Crowd says yes, he was using hair. Past the 4 minute mark with 11 minutes to wrestle. To talk about it a little. He'd like to take a few minutes out to sing us a song right here. He's got him a tough young competitor in Alan West. Pounded that head on the top turnbuckle. Of his mouth as he pulled back on it. The referee broke him up. Big knee lift, and boy, that is something Bass does very well. He has such a big you feel like you ran right smack into a Mack truck when he hits you with that knee lift. Alan West is staggered, tried to beat him there with an elbow, but Bass was on top of him too tight. And a chop. Alan's got a new haircut. Looks a little different. He feels a little different right now with Don Bass now starting to pop it to him. We could see the side of his hand. He jammed him right straight in the throat with that. Once again, I couldn't tell exactly. It went for his eyes, obviously. Don Bass will cut loose with a series of things like that. Just one after the other. The eyes, the choke, you name it. Alan West in the corner is the referee counting on Bass. Look at Alan. From his knees, grabs a foot, but it doesn't stick. Powerful legs, Don Bass, and he continues to work right at those eyes. Now the throat.
Coming up Wednesday night. I'll tell you what. Hey, before we get to Jeff and Bubba, let me remind you there's not only going to be the big main event where Jerry Lawler and Brickhouse Brown get it on in there, there will be a U.S. tag title defense when Steve Kern and Ron Simmons defend against the Nasty Boys. The Moondogs, crazy as they are, will be in the ring. with Jeff Jarrett and Big Bubba.
Well, I'll tell you, Lance, these moon dogs are real rough and tough, and they attack Jeff from behind in the middle of a wrestling match. Well, let me explain something to you, moon dogs. The next time you're in the ring with me and Jeff, he's going to be looking right across at us, and I hope you're prepared because it's going to be face-to-face this time.
That's right, Bubba. Lance said it all. It's going to be all two-on-two this time. It's not going to be two-on-one. Hey, let me tell you something, Moondogs. I'm not going to get out here and holler and scream. I'm just going to settle the problem in the ring right there in Evansville.
Hey, a match that's coming up also is a martial arts match with Diamond and Tanaka and Dundee and Johnson. This Tanaka, you got to give him credit. He knows what he's doing.
Yeah, he does. And his manager's supposed to know what he's doing, but if you read the fine print, Daddy, it's a kind of change just from the martial arts, because Eddie Marlin said this could happen. I'm going to have this chain because Diamond likes to run away, so you can't run away, punk. You're going to be on the other end of it, and the superstar going to be on the other end, Jack, and I'm going to beat your brains out. Now, when it comes to fighting, boxing, loving, dancing, there ain't nobody does nothing better than this, brother, so tell him so,
man. That's right, Bill, I'm not going to sell Diamond short. I know he's very good in martial arts, but he forgot one thing. I think the whole wrestling world knows, Lance. I know how to use these little bit, maybe boxing, quite a bit. Yeah. So, hey, you can put on all your karate gear, brother, and you can bring it on in and do your kickboxing, and all I got to do is get that right hand in, because the big right hand might send you to the promised land.
Hey, that's, and this is all in the ring at the same time.
All four in the ring at the same time, brother.
Woo! What a while. George Barnes will be in Evansville also. He's got a bout coming up.
Mr. Russell, there's something that's got me puzzled about this match. Shouldn't Rocky Johnson have that chain around him? Because him and he's kind of more used to having chains around them.
George, we'll be seeing Evansville Wednesday. Believe you have double odd trouble, and here he comes, the roughneck from Jackson, Tennessee, Big Phil. David?
Well, weighs in at 279 pounds. Jeff Jarrett out of Nashville at 201. One foul, 15-minute time limit match, and Gary Calhoun, the referee, Jeff Jarrett. Oh, wait. A couple
right
of
away.
Shots from that right arm for Big Phil Hickerton. Phil is a vicious wrestler. I mean, he goes in there like a mad dog, just right after his opponent. Wastes no time getting started. Backbreaker on Jeff. He's got a cover. Count is two, Jeff. Able to break out of it at the two count. Boy, when you got a 279-pound cover, I didn't know if Jeff was going to be able to break that one or not.
Fortunately, his athletic power really helped him out, as he's given away plenty of weight to Hickerson. It's nothing new for him, and look at him pound away on Big Phil. Phil wanted to get rough. Jefferson ready to get it right back at him. Clothesline puts Phil down, but Hickerson didn't take him long to shake Jeff off into an arm bar.
Phil Hickerson raked his hand. I think he got Jeff in the eyes. Follows with a forearm smash. Boy, this guy's powerful.
Yeah, he really is. And as you mentioned, when he comes out to hurt you.
Oh, yeah.
It's just, that's a lifestyle with Phil. He puts an elbow up there that knocks the feet right out from under Jeff Jarrett. Whips him across. Misses with a big elbow. That great drop kick. A beauty. Boy, that drop kick.
Look out. Moondogs attacking Jeff Jarrett. Bruno sends him in here. This match is going to end in disqualification. Look out, they got the dog collar on Jeff Jarrett. Moondog spot. With the dog collar on Jeff. Phil Hickerson leaves the area. He's lost by disqualification here.
Isn't the first one Phil's lost by disqualification, but he was a little hacked off that I think he ended up losing that one when he had a chance to beat Jeff Jarrett right here on television. He felt like, oh man.
Goodness.
Hey.
Bubba. That's going to get rid of the Moondogs and Bruno.
Big Bubba comes out, and I'll tell you, that'll pull an end to a lot of arguments in there when Bubba comes walking into the room.
Boy,
Moondogs and Bruno took off. Time again, Dave?
Time, a minute, 44 seconds. Jeff wins it by DQ.
1:44. We'll take time out while Big Bubba is ministering to Jeff over there. We'll be back in just a moment.
Today on Championship Wrestling. I hope you have too. Be sure to tell a friend about us. We're right here each and every week for Championship Wrestling action. We saw some rough, tough tag teams, some outstanding young wrestlers in action, some wily veterans, some good single wrestlers in action. The best in Championship Wrestling is right here. You can book that. Until next week, Michael St. John saying, we'll see you at ringside.